Welcome. In this video, we are going to turn on Twig debug mode. Twig debug mode is extremely helpful when you are investigating exactly which template you need to override to get the output you need. This is important because when Drupal is rendering HTML in a way that needs to be adjusted for your theme, you can override it. Overriding simply refers to the process of replacing existing core and contributed module templates in your theme. To override an existing template, we do three things. First, we locate the existing template we wish to override. Then we make a copy of it. This is important because we don't ever want to edit core templates. And then finally, we place the copy of that template file in our theme's templates folder. Twig debug helps us identify which template file we need to make a copy of to place in our theme's template directory. So let's do this now. Follow along to enable Twig debug mode. However, first, let's add some content to our site because this will help us more easily identify the Twig debug mode in action. So bring up your local Drupal site and let's add a basic page. Of course, you can type anything you'd like, but for the title, I will type quotes. For the body, I'll start with something simple like, individually, we are one drop. Together, we are an ocean. Click Save. And when you are ready, right-click anywhere on the page and view page source. Take a quick scan through, realizing that if we wanted to change the HTML of an element on this page, it is not super obvious which template we would need to override. Let's make it easier for us by enabling Twig debugging. To do that, go ahead and open your file browser with the files of your site loaded. Your location will be different, but the location of my site files are at Home, Sites, ThemeSpark. When you are ready to navigate, navigate to Web, Sites, and Default. Here, we need to make sure that we have an active services.yaml file. For me, I need to copy this default.services.yaml file and duplicate it, and then rename it to simply services.yaml. If you already have a services.yaml file, work with your existing file. After you have duplicated the file, we need to make a change to it to one of the settings. Open the settings.yaml file in your code editor. To quickly find the setting that we need to change, I'm going to search this document for the text debug colon. Then, likely somewhere around line 74, you'll see the setting we need to change from false to true. Be sure to read these comments for more details about this setting, like how it should not be enabled on a production environment, for example. After you have set debug to true, be sure to save the file and then head back to your site. The first thing we need to do, and it should be a habit by now, is flush the cache. Do this now. After you have flushed the cache, be sure to again inspect the HTML source of the quotes page for comparison. This time, you'll encounter much more details as comments in the page source. Here, we can see that this page is using node.html.twig to render this basic page. We know this because there is this X next to the list of file name suggestions. Excellent. So this concludes our discovery of enabling Twig debugging. You'll likely use it many times and you'll become more efficient at looking at this page source to identify which templates you need. Remember to not enable Twig debugging on production sites. This is all for now. See you in the next videos. Happy learning.